I'm Michelle. I joined the Wash spring 2010. First year.
Okay, my name is Krista O'Connell. I joined first semester my first year.
My name's Chris, and I joined my first semester first year, which was fall of 2009.
Zach Levin. When did we join the Wash?
I think we joined in fall of 2010.
Okay.
Yeah. Second, first semester of our second year.
My name is Sophia Armstrong, and I joined the second semester of my first year, so I guess that's spring of 2010.
I am Tom Crossland. I joined fall of 2011.
I'm Sam Kerrigan, and I guess that means I joined the fall of 2010.
My name is Nicole Ballister, and I joined the first semester of my fourth year last semester.
My name is Jonathan DeLorenzo, and I joined the same time as you did.
My name is Elizabeth Garrett, and I joined at the same time both of them did.
John Birmingham.
Hammer?
Yes. All right. I joined my second semester, or first semester, second year. There we go. So that would be fall 2010.
I'm Allie, and I joined spring of my first year.
Oh, Jamie. Fall of my first year. Fall 2009.
2009.
I'm Lillian, joined
fall 2009. Well, the brutally honest answer is that I wanted to join the Jeff and I went to their interviews and they made me cry. So I decided not to ever go back to them. And I don't know. I just really like the environment the Wash portrayed. Honestly, the first time I went, it scared me a little bit. Everybody pounding and hissing. And Joanna Schoenbaum and Owen were debating, so a little intimidating, but I remember I went back to the humorous meeting, and Bud Lobb debated something about zombies. It was just hilarious. I had never seen so much wit and just intelligent humor before, so I was like, I need to be around these people.
Intelligent.
I joined because Michelle Fox, who graduated 2 years ago, I went to high school with her, and she had mentioned the society. It was like 3 weeks into school, and I was like, you know, not really involved in anything. So I emailed her, and she gave my email to Chris Hebbich, who emailed me. Probably one of the most awkward emails I've ever received. So I heard, you heard about the Washington Times. And I was like, oh my god, I guess I have to go now. And so I did, and it was signing of the role, so I also felt like I had to sign the role. And so yeah, they kind of trapped me that way.
How we do
haven't
it.
Left.
So. How we do it in the Wash.
I joined the Wash because I found out that it wasn't just the, like an inside joke of the Jeff, because that's what I thought it was my first semester when I saw posters for it. And then I became friends with Krista, and then Krista had me come, and I went to chapel, and I came to chapel so I couldn't hear anything, so it was actually in chapel. And then I stuck around.
That was the last time I was in chapel, wasn't it?
Yes, it sucks.
Okay, so Sophia Armstrong came home one day, we were in the same suite, and she was like, I'm joining the Washington Society, apparently. I don't know what that meant, but I was like, okay. And I saw, nope, I went to the chapel meeting. Yeah, it was in the chapel. I think that was the last meeting we ever had in the chapel. And some dude gave a rap, and I was like, I like this society. And then the next debate was, tights are not pants. And I was like, I really like this society. And then it was all downhill from there.
My friend Connolly had told me about this really cool society. Connolly and I had gone to high school together and we were on a debate team there. And she was like, this Wash Society is really cool. They like accept anyone. And her twin sister was trying out for the Jeff. And we were like, that's lame. We don't want to try out for that. So we came to the Wash and we thought it was really cool. And we saw a chapel meeting and Sarah Pergolese giving a lit. And Hayden giving minutes, which were really bizarre but really funny, and we joined.
So, when I was a probie, during our inductions, one of our tasks was to write a rap about Mr. Washington. So, I remember Pooja was in my group, and Carlo, who never comes around anymore, but he was awesome, and we had him perform the rap, and at some point, I became Martha Washington, and we were like grinding on the steps of the rotunda. It was pretty weird.
My best memory is probably the chapel meeting from my first meeting I went to with Chris, and Krista debating.
Oh, that was a good one.
That was a good one.
I honestly did not know you were in our furry class.
Me and Krista agreed to wear seersucker, and then Chris Savage and Chris Ranifers both showed up in seersucker.
Savage was wearing a cardigan.
Douchebags. Okay, he had a pink cardigan around the seersucker.
He said it was the best versatile garment in the world.
I really like the 1920s party, the Great Gatsby party. That was a really good party.
That was enjoyable. I like bartending that party.
I liked participating in the humorous debate because it was my first time in a debate in front of the entire society, and I got to write my own jokes, and it was really fun.
The favorite memory is probably the ones I can't remember.
I'd go first. It's my favorite memory. It was getting to debate in the Harrison Cup this past fall, and winning that.
Well, what would you say your favorite?
Mine would be the Harrison Cup the year before, I think.
Oh, yeah! What's that? Because we have two Harrison Cup winners right here.
Yeah. Yeah. Back to back.
So I borrowed some tights from Hayden Lewis because I needed to have this, like, you know, I needed tights for the tights debate so I could prove their pants. If I wore them as pants, they would be pants. And I thought it'd be funny to stick a banana inside the tights because, you know, they'll look really funny, right? Well, Seth K shows up after the debate and he's like, man, that was great. And he grabs the banana in my tights and it explodes. And he makes all these jokes about, oh, you exploded all over Hayden's tights. But then I had to give them back to Hayden and they had banana stain, like, right in an uncomfortable place in the tights. But it went over well, yeah.
I'm torn between two things. My favorite memory in the wash is giving a certain lit with a certain Claire Ryberg. About sluts. That was fun. And my favorite memory with a washi was probably this one time in Amsterdam when I was with Heather Medlin and we were on a tour and I just happened to walk into a hole and we wound up in the emergency room. And yeah, that was fun.
We were just talking about this one. It was, I guess we were first years. We were first years and Emma was second year and she had never streaked the lawn.
And we were just like, well, we have to streak the lawn.
Yeah, right. But we was at a meeting, and Emma was sober.
And I had, like, a beer, maybe.
Yeah, we weren't really that drunk, but it was also 10
It was during break between lit and debate.
Yeah, so we just did it, and then Emma rode away on her bike.
And it was really weird, because everyone was, like, really confused that we were streaking at 10 p.m.
Yeah, they were like,
that happens at 2 a.m.
Right, so we start early in the morning.
I guess just enjoy the ride. The wash it always changes, so enjoy at all the different variations of the wash that you're gonna encounter.
I would advise myself to attempt to write more and to debate more, which I never really did. I don't like how the debates are usually monopolized by provies, and I wish I had more experience doing that, because I'm still not very good at it, not even close.
I would definitely tell my Provy self to put herself out there more because I was a sad little first year and I was very shy.
Don't be the treasurer. That shit sucked. Sorry, Troy. Provy me. One day you won't have the chance to drink Four Loko. So even though it's bad, you should go for it while you have the chance. Be the fucking man. There we go. That's my... To all future Probies as well, not just me, Proby.
Chris Savage is not as scary as you think he is. He's not that intimidating. He's not even that funny. I mean, he is funny, but, like, he's not so funny that you can't talk to him.
Don't go to Savage's pregame for inductions, because I missed induction. Not really, technically.
Yeah, you were technically there for a split second, and the bushes bombing.
Yeah.
I was there for about 5 more minutes before I was in the bathroom bombing.
I wish that I would have read some of the things that I've written or finished writing things I had in progress before the wash, because I think that's some of the most valuable times at the wash, and you can hear things that were written by the members that you would literally never be able to hear anywhere else besides the wash, because anyone can read a lit. I mean, of course, some presentations are great and you can't reproduce them, but I wish that I had been more involved in that and just had, there were times where I didn't come to the wash for various reasons. I wish I stuck it out more, because now there are less and less opportunities to go to meetings since we're graduating, which is really sad, actually. It really makes me sad. like that.
I want to say I enjoyed, like, the dictatorial power of it.
You did.
Kind of. Yeah.
Best part of being a special debates chair was planning that debate, the humorous debate against the Jeff, where it was Maggie, Chris, and Julia Dalby, and it was great, because we crushed the Jeff, and then after that, they were really reluctant to plan things with us, which is also funny.
It was getting to know all the probies, absolutely. That was my favorite part, because everyone was different, everyone was there for different reasons, and you really just get to know them really well, and you're always, like, really proud for anything, like, with anything that they do.
I really, really love just getting up and delivering the minutes. Like, little confession here, that most of my minutes were written, I think on Thursdays, starting at like 4 p.m., 4 hours before the meeting. Yeah. So Sam can attest to me lying on his floor, saying, what the fuck am I going to write this week? But I always like manage to get some sort of idea and just run with it. And then just having that finished product and presenting it, just always felt so fulfilling.
So I was Proby Chair. Definitely the best part of that is getting to like meet all the probies, get to know all
Proby
of them.
Proby trolling?
What?
Proby trolling?
We don't troll our probies.
They're gonna see this after tonight.
Exactly.
It'll
That's
be fine.
I want
we'll already
them to
know
that
thing.
We love each and every one of you. And you're special and unique.
My favorite part was probably the reward, like as Sarge, seeing people having fun at parties, or as vice president, seeing like probies getting really involved and really into the society, and then being involved and being at OC even after they were inducted.
It gives you a really great thing to do on Sundays at 5.
Best part of being vice president was probably, as much as I complained about it, getting to see the Proby lits twice each and getting to see the Proby debates form. Because when you get to see a lit happen twice, you get to see the first time, it's like, you can tell the Proby cares about the lit. Yeah, you can tell the Proby cares about the lit, and then the second time you can tell that they care about it and like have the presentation skills to share that love. And when you get to give someone advice on it and see them improve from that advice, and the debate, getting to see people like talk about issues that they care about and then turn that into like a way to share issues that they care about with people that they care about, is really fun.
The stubbornness of everyone and everything, and I'm stubborn too, so I'm part of this guilty group, but I feel like at OC we always discuss things, and each one of us are stubborn for something, whether it's tradition, what we've always done, or stubborn about, you know, like, we should be respectful of everyone, even though we're a free speech society or whatever. Just each one of us is very stubborn about what we believe in.
We should bar the brownies.
You got a little bit of a point. Don't bar the brownies.
I'm not going to justify it. I'm just going to make it.
I think especially with last semester's probies, you really see probies challenging themselves to give like the best list they can.
They were awesome. They were pretty
cool. Last semester's probies ruled because he's VP. And
they were great.
Worked with them, but I think if we can move in that direction of having people serious about doing lists and debates, but not in a like grave or like dark way, like I'm so serious, but just because they're passionate about it and excited, and they want to make the best of their time.
I think my secret favorite washi is Maggie Wood. Yeah. Every time I talk to Maggie Wood, I'm glad that I did.
I could talk to Maggie Wood for hours.
Yeah, it's just
accident.
A funny conversation. And it, like, she always like makes me smile for some reason. And I don't know her very well. I don't really hang out with her, but she's good to have around.
I wish I'd talk to Maggie Wood more.
I mean, there are people who just really present themselves as fantastic characters. Jose comes to mind. Maggie Wood is another person. It's just awesome at speaking. Honestly, Cameron Johnson. It's really hard to find people who can be funny spontaneously.
He is probably one of the best stand-up comedians that I've ever seen.
Probably Sam Kerrigan.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's a good
actor. You're always just, you want to hear, he's like raising him for
every time.
Like,
yeah.
Yes.
Every time he says something, I immediately believe what he said.
You're like, that, I wish I could.
Every time he writes a column in the Cab Daily, I'm like, yeah.
Duh. So obvious now.
I mean, I really enjoy the times I've spent with Claire and Lara and Rachel and Heather and I mean, I've had a lot of different memories, a lot of different favorites.
Probably Owen. Right? Yeah, like, you know what I mean? Like, you never show liking for Owen publicly, ever. But secretly, you're like, that Owen, he's a great guy.
He really is. I mean, no, he's such a jackass to your face.
Yeah.
And then, like, you share a cigarette with him outside by yourself, and you're like, oh, really nice.
Troy Singer. Motley.
Weird.
No.
Fucked up. If there's a hyphen, that makes it one word, right?
Exquisite.
Incestuous? Rambunctious.
Bloviating? That's my word. Bloviating. It's the gerund, the adjective form of the word bloviating. Because we talk a lot. I think Meet Your Soulmate and Show Us Your Tits are two sides of the
coin. Yeah, of the coin.
Very few people do either of those things. No one does both of those things. But you can drink. Chris, would you say The Wash is a good place to meet your soulmate?
Of all the places to meet a soulmate, no. I mean, I got lucky, but good God, there's some weird people in The Wash.